see the quarterback is James Jackson, number 14. Man in motion to the left, and here comes Lars Tate. Power sweep to the right. Down at the 22 by Ron Sancho. Now, it is the problem of Ron Sancho and Eric Hill to take the place of the departed Michael Brooks, LSU's All-America outside linebacker. This is the way they set up in the front three and
retain the football and keep Georgia's offense off the field.
There's the Georgia eye with James Jackson, number 14, down under. Bootleg this way. Chased by Sancho. Sancho gets him at the 21. A yard short of a first down. Nice call and a good play for Jackson.
And watch the play. A good fake by Jackson with his quickness. He makes the fake. Ron Sancho, you see there, when he took that step inside, he knew, I shouldn't have done it. His responsibility is to get as deep as the deepest man in the backfield and not allow himself to be outrun. He made the mistake. He recognized it and came back and made a fine play. But Jackson with an excellent fake for a long yardage, 9 yards on first down.
This week, and I want to tell you an interesting thing or two about that hot game in Gainesville, Florida, 1 week ago. Look how widely set the LSU defensive line is there. There's Tate again. They're lying in the gap for him. The ball, the play was turned in by Greg Jackson, and Ron Sancho makes the tackle. Last week down at Gainesville, when the floor of the...
...and hurt by the long pass play, Georgia has not been able to take advantage of that because the LSU pass rush, I think, has been more effective tonight than it has at any time earlier this season.
Georgia, third and one. The Tigers bunch up defensively. Point of the down, the Tiger 42. First down, not by a lot, but enough. Now that is a power play right up the middle that Georgia probably has a patent on. They have that tailback set very deeply, and he has plenty of time to run.
Behind the receiver, Henderson was wide open there for the reception.
That Florida State's lead of 8 points over Tulane is at the half. We have 4:10 to play in the first half here, and there's Henderson breaking a tackle behind the line, attempted by Barbe, but he's finally polished off by Ron Sancho. On a first down run, he stopped at the 38-yard line. That gain was for 4 yards, a second down, and a long six to go. In motion is David Dukes, number 10. Here comes Tate with the ball. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. The Tigers have that one. Defense led by Greg Jackson, number 35. Darren Marlborough, number 90, and Ron Sancho, who would not leave home on the defensive play.
That type of...
...the yard. Nine to go at the LSU 16-yard line. There's the clock showing 1:32 to play in the half. The Tigers lead precariously 10-7, and the game is heating up. Is flanked to the right. There goes the running back McCluskey, who scored early on a pass reception. He's up to 7. May have a first down. Sancho makes the tackle for the Tigers. That's that cut back off an apparent sweep or an off tackle play.
And George is blocking this as they would the off tackle or the sweep play to
the Tigers lead by 3. And here is Jackson to the right side, wants to throw. He's going to have to run. He's open to the 5. He's going to score to the side. Jackson scores, fumbles after the fact, and Georgia bullets out in front. There's no substitute for speed.
None whatsoever, and you see there why Vince Dooley feels that this youngster is a great football player. He is being pursued by Ron Sancho, who came just a whisker away from tackling him. Look at Sancho, almost got him, but was not able to get his arms around him. But Jackson's quickness and speed allows him to get across the goal line. The ball is knocked out of his arms by Chris Carrier, but he was already in the end zone. Touchdown. Defense in the secondary is coming up so fast to stop that run. George is using that to their own advantage in the passing game.
Here's the reverse play. The Tigers have it figured. Good play by Tommy Clapp. Way behind the line, Fred Lane is stopped at the Georgia 46-yard line. Let's look at that one again. That's a sterling defensive play for the Tigers.
And this is the type of play. Remember, earlier in the ball game, a mistake was made by Sancho. Look at Ron Sancho. He didn't make the same mistake again. He half, both stayed home and made the play.
1:56 to play in the half to go for a first down, just outside the Tiger 7. Georgia with the ball. Third down, big play here, that's Henderson in motion. Here is Tate, first down at the 6. Didn't get a lot, but he got enough there. Georgia going for it at the LSU 36-yard line. We told you they're pulling out all stops, and here's Georgia going for first down on a 4th-and-3 at the Tiger 36-yard line. Jackson is going to throw way down there, incomplete, too far for Lane. The Tigers take over at their own 36-yard line. A big play in this game.
What makes this play is a great play of Ron Sancho. He's at right side linebacker to your left. He comes in and he keeps his position. He makes Jackson stop. And so Jackson was not able to scramble to the outside and had to throw a very difficult pass.
That's the point you made on the previous play.
Exactly. Fine play by Sancho and really in an important part of this ball game.
First, second down from the 23. 7 to go. Henderson stumbling along, stuck his head down, and went right into the middle of Greg Jackson, who stopped it. Sancho has a helping hand there. The LSU defense has allowed only 10 second half points this year, and they'll be sorely tested right now by the Georgia Bulldogs. Second and 3, the Bulldogs are at their 25, down by 3 points. McCleskey looking for room. First down, he stopped at the 30. And Georgia has the ball, first down at the Bulldog 25. 9:54 to play in the game. That's Lane in motion to the left, out of an eye. And Jackson is backing up to rifle it. He's being chased by Thomas. Sancho makes a bone-crushing tackle of him at about the 27-yard line.
Ron Sancho is something else. He says he's not even the best athlete in his family. Have a hard time believing that, because he's taken what he thinks is mediocre talent and turned it into a pretty solid football player. Watch him come up and make a tough open field tackle on James Jackson. He's in the right place at the right time. A real asset to this LSU defense.
Ron Sancho from Avondale, played high school football at Shaw High School. Here's a pass completion up the field.
Georgia up to the 45.
Tigers have 3 down linemen, an extra defensive back on the field, and it's going to be another pass as Jackson is chased out of the pocket again. They've got him this time. And credit that tackle to Henry Thomas. And guess who else is there? Ron Sancho. Sancho earned second-team freshman All-America honors from Football News last year. He posted 72 tackles and finished 4th on the team in that category.
Good solid defensive pass rush here. Jackson goes back, and he gets rushed from both sides and runs straight up the middle. That's the only place to go, and here comes Sancho right there. Henry Thomas with good pursuit to make the tackle.
Defensively, Toby Caston was involved in 22 tackles. He had 12 solo tackles, so he would have to be one of the defensive stars along with Ron Sancho. Generally, the whole team played very effectively.